This all started when I wanted to learn a bit about finance on YouTube, so I started searching for investing related videos, and I realized one guy kept coming up. So I watched a few of his videos, and I was on my merry way. But then, YouTube started recommending loads of his videos on my homepage. So intrigued, I asked myself, why was YouTube recommending a financial education channel? So I did a little bit of digging, and I realized that YouTube wasn't just recommending his channel to me, this guy was huge, and his videos were recommended all over YouTube. But how was he doing this? How was a YouTube educator talking about such a dry topic such as finance and real estate blowing up on YouTube? And I found that there was a system that Graham Stephen was using. And this simple formula is one that you can use as well. So, in pursuit of said formula, I analyzed all of his top videos, all of his recent videos. I basically watched a lot of Graham Stephen's videos. So that you don't have to spend hours analyzing them, let me show you exactly how to implement that system for your channel. At first glance, you might be a bit skeptical, and you might think that a channel with 3.4 million subscribers that just does educational videos is unattainable. Well, so did Graham.
Talking about me doing YouTube and me saying like, I know it's never gonna make as much as I make on as a real estate agent, but I'm just having so much fun with it.
But a system worked for him and it's going to work for YouTube. And like every great YouTube system, it all starts with a reaction. Graham has mastered the title and thumbnail game. And it wouldn't be surprising to let you know that he has been doing titles and thumbnails even before YouTube. Analyzing one of his interviews, he talks about how in real estate, he used to put stuff up on Craigslist and he used to optimize titles to get more clients.
I would come up with different titles, different main pictures, different layouts of like putting my phone number at the top, putting like Graham Stephan, Global Banker versus just like call Graham. I found that just call Graham number got a better response than call Graham Stephan or call Graham Stephan Coldwell Banker, just call Graham. I guess it was more approachable.
So it's not surprising that Graham has gotten really, really good at this. All of his titles have two elements to them. The SEO value, so in titles that have Tesla, credit card, or real estate, for people searching for those terms. But unlike most channels in his niche, he doesn't write them for the algorithm, he also writes them for humans. So all of his titles have some SEO value, but they're not fixated at trying to get search traffic as much as they are fixated at getting you to be intrigued and to click. But like every great title, it has to have a great thumbnail. And if we look at Graham Stephan's thumbnail, they always exaggerate the title. You can find him with some intriguing look on his face or some exaggerated emotion on his face or text to amplify the purpose of the video, which is something that most channels, especially when he started, weren't doing. So even if finance is a dry topic, he would be able to make it interesting and intriguing by showing you the cool and interesting parts of the video. But what's more amazing about his thumbnails is that they're just as amazing when we zoom out. Because when YouTubers are editing thumbnails, they're editing them on huge screens on a desktop, but people see them on mobile on tiny screens. So Graham makes sure that his thumbnails are recognizable on the tiniest of devices. And he takes his titles and thumbnails so seriously that he scraps some videos if he can't find a good title or thumbnail.
And I first start out with the topic and title. Like, if I can't get a good title for a video, I don't make the video. So I first will think of what title can I use for this.
But titles and thumbnails are just half of the job. Because once you click, if it's dry and boring, you would click off. And this is where the second part of his system comes into play. Graham isn't a boring professor trying to teach you economics. He's a finance guy trying to build a community. And he builds that community through transparency and inside jokes, which are two things that you wouldn't associate with some buttoned-up finance guy. But this is exactly why Graham is amazing at this. He has a lot of inside jokes like these.
What's up, Graham? It's Guys here. No matter how much I would watch Matt D'Avella trying to find the next big revelation or correct my posture throughout the day, hoping that would lead to more efficient creativity.
So these jokes make people feel like he is relatable. And what makes him even more relatable is his transparency. He doesn't try to flex or use hard jargon to explain financial topics, and he shows you exactly how much he's making from his business ventures, not to flex, but to show you that you can do it too. And this is one thing that most education channels get wrong. They talk down to the people, but don't make them feel like they're part of a community. You make them feel like they're just students. But if I'm completely honest, neither his personality or his amazing titles and thumbnails would work if it weren't for the third and most vital part of his system, and it's the ideas. At the end of the day, when you click on a video, you are intrigued by not the title and thumbnail alone, but for the idea. And even if the title and thumbnail intrigue intrigues you a bit, you stick around towards the end because of the idea. But how does he find great ideas? If you look at Graham's channel, there are two types of content. The topical content, which is reacting to the news and reacting to new things in the financial space. And there's the evergreen content, like his tutorials or his how-to videos. And these two work together brilliantly to cultivate his audience, because he stays up to date with trends and very relevant topical videos, but his channel has a lot of evergreen content. So if someone finds Graham's channel through a topical video, they can then watch all of his value-packed stuff and vice versa. So his channel is the complete package to financial education. But there's a lot of channels that try to do that, but they miss a vital thing that Graham excels at, is that education on YouTube has to be entertained. And if you look at this video from Graham about taxes, which is one of the most historically dry topics ever, you can see exactly what I mean.
Well, here's where things get interesting. There's a loophole that allows you to get around those pesky income requirements by contributing to a traditional IRA first, which doesn't have an income limit, and then immediately converting that to a Roth, and voila! You can now contribute to a Roth IRA regardless of how much money you make.
Most teachers don't put in the effort to make their videos entertaining. So no matter how relevant the idea is, or no matter how value-packed it is, no one's going to watch it. But when it's relevant, value-packed, people want to come back and watch it and learn.
But I think it goes to show you that, like, I really always did it for fun. It was never about the money. I love doing it.
In the comments, I challenge you to find the most boring topic that you couldn't stand learning about, and I will try to find a creator that does entertaining videos on that topic. And if you like this type of content where I break down why creators are successful, you might enjoy this video where I show you exactly how a creator made 2 billion views on his channel by teaching science. I'll see you guys in the next one.